Google NotebookLM has long been one of the most popular note-taking apps on the market, and there haven't been many competitors until now. Today, we're looking at an app that we've reviewed here on the channel that is adding some powerful AI knowledge base features that will allow you to chat with your notes globally and really build an AI encyclopedia of your life. And we're doing a news announcement today, breaking down some of their new features. So big thanks to Recall for sponsoring today's video. So the Recall team have given me 25% off for you guys to get access to these features. You can sign up for free, but there is a plus account which gives you unlimited access to all of the features. Get 25% below and save yourself some money as you get started. So what's new with Recall? They're announcing a major update to their chat-based features, which means that you can bring all of the knowledge that you've been putting into Recall and actually make even more sense of it. So basically think of this as like NotebookLM with unlimited sources and a pool of your knowledge that is automatically tagged for you. So let's start with what Recall actually is. So as I mentioned, I've reviewed Recall here on the channel. You can find that full breakdown below, but essentially it's a self-organizing workspace that you can bring loads of different sources in, whether that's a Spotify podcast all the way to a YouTube video and whatever it may be, a PDF, whatever you want. And it will basically organize it for you into different areas. So say you're uploading a research paper about, I don't know, creatine, it'll organize that into a science and fitness area for you. Say you're uploading a YouTube video about Ferrari's latest win, it'll add that to a motorsport section. Now from here, you can add tags, categorize them to add that extra little bit layer to your organization. And you can use it as a knowledge graph of all of your ideas and bring them together. And if you want to quick import elements, you can import from Pocket, which is recently shut down. And you can also bring in from Markdown as well to save you a bunch of time. If you're also on the browser, you can import your existing bookmarks as well, which may save you a bunch more time too. So what's this latest feature about? Basically, you can chat with your knowledge base, meaning that all of the notes that you have saved as part of your Recall account can now be pulled inside the chat area, which means you can extract important insights around all the notes that you saved that are tailored and curated by you. So say you're looking to bring together some notes that you've taken around an exam that you've got and you've tagged that exam across multiple notes, then you can do that. You can create that summary really easily, making it slightly different to alternatives like ChatGPT, where all that knowledge is pulled by you and brought together. Now, Recall has a Chrome extension, which basically allows you, it has Firefox as well, which allows you to bring in stuff really easily, meaning you can clip loads of stuff throughout the web and add those tags as you go, meaning it's like this constant curated platform to bring all the most important stuff in. So think of a YouTube video, you could capture the information through it through a concise summary or a detailed summary. Both of them give you a breakdown of timestamps and all the insights you need that are based on the transcript. And in the new version, you can also chat with the source content, meaning you can essentially break things down or ask questions within the browser, which is really helpful. There is also a way to see the reader version of this, as well as the connections to this card. And if you don't have any, you can generate some. So if you don't know the basic abilities in Recall, then essentially what you can do is bring in sources from a wide variety of insights. And on the left-hand side, you can see the notebook and you could basically start building that card out. You can even take your own notes, or you can use the chat individually on a note. This is really helpful, which means you can break down a note, ask it questions, and really take advantage of that source. But most importantly, it goes a step further. You can create a quiz from this, and you can also see the relationships between the notes that you've created, as well as the overarching parent card, which helps to structure that note out. So on top of the web clipper and the chat quiz features that are baked inside of each card, you can also use something called augmented browsing, which essentially can be accessed through the extension settings, needs to be enabled there. And essentially from there, you'll be able to use Recall as a way to see notes within things like articles, mentions, across the web. So you're essentially getting this real-time awareness of what you saved into your account and how they connect up to things that you've already curated in Recall. So if you compare this right now to NotebookLM, then it has actually got more sources collectively. So you can bring in more than 50 items and they're all curated around that. They're not distilled to folders, they can be distilled to tags and beyond as a collective resource for bringing those notes in. It also has other abilities it doesn't have, like the ability to chat with each individual note, take quizzes per note and card that you create in Recall, and a knowledge graph for seeing how all of your notes are collected together. So overall, Recall is a really interesting offering. It's something that I've been keeping an eye of in the background. And as you can imagine, I think that idea of a self-organizing notes area is becoming much more the future of note-taking. The administration you typically took with a note-taking app should be a thing of the past. And this is a great example, especially for those who curate and bring together information. You can also create your own notes in there, means you're not only distilled to a source that you can bring in, but incredibly valuable if you have those sources to add to your full encyclopedia of information. So I hope you enjoyed this video and breakdown of Recall. You can find it below, as always, and you can find out more tools over on toolfinder.co that both complement Recall and go beyond. Thank you so much for stopping by. I hope this helped you, and I'll see you again in a future video. Cheerio for now.